Hey, what's up YouTube? In this video, I have another weird modern house for you. Yeah, this is a bit of a strange one. This is what I'm calling the Cylinder Modern House. I think that you guys will be able to see where it gets its name from. It's made of three circles, all attached to each other, all varying heights and colours. It's definitely a house that sticks out, and it's quite functional, actually. If we take a look inside, if we were to walk inside the entrance, you can see that we have this nice, lovely garden area. I thought that it fit in very nicely with the green. We have this little yellow area, which really doesn't serve too much purpose. We have a nice little library right at the back of the house, but that isn't everything. We have several floors, so if we were to come up to the first floor, we have a nice crafting area, and if we were to come up to the second floor, we would find that we have a little bit more storage, plus we have a bed as well. So it's a nice, pretty small, very easy to make modern house that won't take you an insane amount of time to make. I hope that you guys enjoy this one. Without any further ado, why don't I actually show you how to make this thing? Trust me, it's incredibly easy. So if you want to make it, here's what you'll need. Grab yourself some block of quartz, some quartz slab, some lime hardened clay, some yellow hardened clay, some red hardened clay, lime stained glass, yellow stained glass, and some red stained glass. Of course, if you want to mess about with colours and materials and all that other fun stuff, feel free. I just like the traffic light colours. That's pretty much what this thing is. Change them if you want. I bet that you could get some pretty cool colour combinations. So that's pretty much all you'll need for the outside of the house. Grab each one of those, and once you have those, and once you've figured out where you want to make it, and let me tell you guys, this house surprisingly fits into a 15 block by 15 block area. It's pretty small. So if you want, you can plan out the same square on the floor in your world. If you do that, start on the very front bottom left hand corner of the square, count in to the right by 2, 1, 2, and this is where we will begin the house. So we want to begin by digging into the ground to the right by 5. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that, yeah? We then want to dig into the ground still and do 2 upright diagonals. 1, 2. Then dig upwards by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then do 2 up left diagonals. 1, 2. Left by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do 2 bottom left diagonals. 1, 2. Down by 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, then do a bottom right diagonal. You'll end up with a circular shape that should look like this. Fill in that circular shape using your quartz block or quartz slab. It doesn't really matter. It's just easier to use quartz block, I think. Now, once you've got that sorted out, you want to grab your lime glass and you want to do 2 rows of lime glass on top of this. So that'll be 1 row of lime glass going all the way around. And then, of course, you will then add another one once you've finished the very first layer of the lime glass, which will take, as always, a little bit of time. So we just want to have something which should look like this. Then, what do we want to do? We want to take out our lime-hardened clay, and we want to do a layer of lime-hardened clay that sits above and inside of the shape that we've just made. So it wants to sit above and inside of the shape that we have just made. So basically, you want to end up with something that should look very, very similar to this. Perfect. Now, once you've got that sorted out, all you have to do is, well, actually, we'll be moving on to the next bit before we make any alterations to that. So once you've got that sorted out, you now want to move all the way over to the right-hand side of your cylinder, of your circle, and where we have this row of 5, you want to take the second block coming in from the row of 5. So you want to take the second block, and you want to go to the right of it by 1. You want to dig into the ground again, go to the right of it by 1. Then do 2 upright diagonals from this block, 1 and 2 in the ground, so that's second upright diagonal. I know that I've kind of knocked into the ground accidentally, pretend that I didn't do that. Then go up by 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, do 2 up left diagonals, 1, 2, left by 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, do 2 bottom left diagonals, 1 and 2, and you should find that, whoops, we actually made a slight error there once again, didn't we? Silly me. 1 and 2, and there we have connected back to the cylinder. So you want to have the same circular shape you guys can see in the ground. That is the shape that you're after. And once again, once you've cut that shape into the ground, we want to fill this in using block of quartz. So we want to, first of all, fill this in with block of quartz. And then this time, we want to take out our yellow stained glass and we want to do rows of 5 yellow stained glass on top of the quartz. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we want to do that all the way up on top of the block of quartz. So we want to do rows of 5 up on top of the block of quartz like this. And that will form the second, the middle, the halfway point for the house. We do also have to do a little bit of extending, but I'll show you guys what I mean by that in just a second. So we've raised up all of those blocks of quartz, right? So you can see we've raised those all up. Take out your yellow hardened clay, and you want to do a layer of yellow hardened clay that once again kind of like sits inside of this half moon shape that we have created using the yellow glass. So it'll kind of look like the letter C-ish, or kind of like a, I don't know, just like a pointy corner sort of thing. But once you have this, what you now want to do, right, you can see where we have these singular yellow stained clays. You want to connect them together diagonally. So if you add rows of 4, so like coming forwards 1, 2, 3, 4 to the back one, and add a row of 4 going left 1, 2, 3, 4, connecting them together in kind of like a square shape like this, what you can then do is you can use this to then use your yellow glass, and you can kind of create a layer of yellow glass that sits around the yellow stained clay that you've placed. And this yellow stained glass wants to kind of like seal in between and together where we have the green glass, if that makes sense to you. So you can see that we're kind of like connecting these two bits together now. We'll create better separations and better distinctions as we move through the build. But that's what you basically want for now. From a top view, you want to have this. Let's do the red one. So come to the very right hand side of your yellow circle. You're looking for, once again, this row of 5, and you want to take the second block coming in from the start. So this block. You want to dig into the ground like this, and then do 2 upright diagonals, still digging into the ground. 1, 2. Move up by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do 2 up left diagonals. 1, 2. Left by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. To bottom left diagonals, 1, 2, and you should see that you have now connected back to the house in a similar fashion as we did earlier. We then want to fill this empty space that we've kind of like just carved into the ground. We want to fill this in with quartz. Then we want to add rows of red glass on top of it. We want to add rows of 8 red glass. So that looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And once again, we want to replicate that over and over and over again until we have like a nice tube. So we just want to have like a tube of red glass. And you guys may have guessed this, once we have raised up all the glass, we'll be doing the exact same thing as we did with the yellow stained clay. We will be making it so that everything connects together, and then we'll be putting a little bit of a trim on the part of the houses, and we will also be like hollowing out the inside. It's far easier to do it this way than to kind of like build in all of the rooms and all of the space and stuff, trust me. So now that you have this little bit of red, we want to take out our red hardened clay, and we once again want to create like that half moon shape that sits inside of the top yet above the red glass. You guys know what this is. It looks a lot like this. We then want to connect these two singular red stained clays together diagonally, so it'll end up looking a little something like that. We then want to use our red glass to create a trim around the red clay like this that will basically seal up the house once it's been done. I'm sure that you guys can do this. We should have already done this one time already on a slightly smaller scale involving the yellow clay. So we want to have something which should look like that. So now you can see that we have each one of the 3 parts of the house. So the next bit is this. We want to take out our quartz slab, and we want to do a layer of quartz slab around the top half of the stained clay. So like the green stained clay, we want to have a layer of quartz slab going around the top half of the green stained clay. We want to do a layer of quartz slab around the top half of the yellow stained clay, like this. And we want to do a layer of quartz slab around the top half of the red stained clay, like this. So, like that, go all the way around. And once we've done this, once we've added this little bit of a trim, not only will it look quite nice because it adds a nice strong colour, or lack of colour really since it's white, but it adds a really nice trim to the place, then we have to fill in the tops of each portion of the house. So for instance, like this green, where we have empty space up at the top of the green bit, we want to fill this in with green. Where we have the top of the yellow bit, we want to fill the top of this in with yellow, as you can kind of see me doing now, like this in between the gaps. And with the red, of course, this one's the easiest one. You can just completely fill this in with red. So we just want to have something which should look a little bit like this. Perfect. We want to create an entrance to the house, which is all the way up front and center. This nice green bit, this is where we enter the house, just as I showed you at the start. Then all you have to do, you'll notice that obviously some parts of the house are walled off. You can keep them separated if you like by only breaking enough glass as you have to. If you want to like keep each one of the like chambers separated, you can. Kind of up to you. You do what you like. If you want to create solid floors, then basically, you know, the part, like, where we have this green, lime green clay area, if you fill in inside of this using your lime clay, this will create an excellent floor for you to utilize on the inside. So you can now use this as a floor if you so want. You can go up on top of the lime clay if you like as well, and then you could create a nice little walkway in which we could add a ladder to, which would take you to the first floor. The same thing could simply also be done with the yellow section, the particular yellow section. We can add some yellow clay up here, like, oh my god, like this. There we go. Always struggle. So we can add some yellow clay here, like that, and then on top of here. And then we can add, once again, like a little staircase, a little bit of a ladder here to take you up to where the bedroom would be. Or you can delete all of the glass, or you can do whatever, it's kind of up to you. The rest of this is completely up in the air. If you want some inspirational ideas, take a look at the start of the video. But that, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, well, what else can I tell you? That is the house fundamentally complete. Like I said, if you want interior ideas, take a look at the start of the video. It'll have everything that you absolutely need. Very simple house, looks great, nice and open, looks very modern. You could even turn it into like really cool sort of eco style house if you want to do. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have, please smack that like button for me. I'd really appreciate it if you could smack that like button. I'd love that tremendously. It really helps me out. If you do like the video, consider subscribing to the channel. If you subscribe, say hello and click the little bell next to the subscription button to ensure that you get all of my videos sent directly to your sub box. I subscribe to loads of YouTubers. If I don't click that little bell, I know that I don't get all of their videos. Some come through, a lot don't. If you do, by the way, want to check out the rest of the channel, and if you want to, by the way, suggest more stuff that you want to see in the future. Do you like these modern houses? Do you want to see more like this? Do you want to see some more cartoon related stuff, some more realistic stuff? Let me know down there in the comment section. Love feedback, it helps me out a lot. But if you want to check out the rest of the channel and all of the other stuff that I do on the channel, you might get a little bit of an idea for what I do on the channel, just taking a little bit of a look around this world. Check out the card system and the description below. That is where you will find all sorts of playlists that will take you to all, well, all sorts of videos, so many, over 1,000 tutorials. If you want more like this, for instance, you check out the Modern House playlist. If you wanted to make something a bit more medieval, maybe the Survival House playlist. If you wanted something a bit more realistic, Suburban House playlist. You guys get the idea. I don't want to talk about that too much. If you enjoyed the video, please do remember to like, subscribe, check out the cards. Hope you have a great day, guys. This is the end of the video. Enjoy the lovely sunshine, which may or may not be available in your country right now. In England, currently, right here, just this day that I'm recording, it's actually quite nice. I'm gonna go and get some sun. Hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you guys in the next one.